The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 7th chapter, text number 1, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on October 27, 1975, in Nairobi, Kenya.
Sri Bhagavan Ubhata, Maya Saptamana Pratya, Yugam Junyan Madasya, Asamsayam Samadram Mam Jathagya Sisi Kachana. Krishna, Bhagavan, discipline. Bhagavan means, Bhaga means opulence. Just like we use the word Bhagavan, from this Bhagga, fortune, comes from the word Bhaga. So, personally, the supreme Bhagavan or Bhagavan, Bhagavan is never unfortunate. If somebody claims that he is Bhagavan, but Bhagavan is never unfortunate. He is always fortunate. Charaiti Bhagavana. There are six kinds of opulences which one possesses in full, he is called Bhagavan. There is meaning. So, there several times explained, Aishadyasya Samakrasya Vidyasya Dasasya Sriya. The Supreme Personality of Godhead, because He is the proprietor of all wealth, Sarvaloka Maheswaram, He is the proprietor of all the planets, all the universes. So who can be fortunate than Him? Bhokkaram Jabhutavasam Sarvaloka Maheswaram. If you have got 1 lakh shillings, 10 lakh shillings, you think we have become very rich. But Krishna says, Sarvaloka Maheswaram. I am the proprietor of all the planets. So who can become richer than Him? Therefore He is Bhagavan. The highest rich man, the richest person, he is called Bhagavan. Nobody can claim that he is the richest. That is not possible. So one who claims that I am the richest, nobody is equal to me, and nobody is greater than me, he is Bhagavan. Mattap parataram nanyat kinchida siddhanam. Nobody is greater than me. That is Bhagavan. Bhagavan cannot be so cheap that anyone can claim that I am God, I am Bhagavan. That is cheating. He must prove, first of all, that he is the richest of everyone. Not only richest, Vaisadyasya samagrasya bijyasya, in strength comes. Bijyasya jasasa, also reputation. Now Krishna is, at least in this material world, in this planet, now everyone knows Krishna. Who is such a person? Who is so famous all over the world. Especially since we have started this Krishna consciousness movement, anywhere we go, they chant Hare Krishna. As soon as they see us, our man, jokingly or seriously, they chant Hare Krishna. When I was first coming to Nairobi from London, the plane stopped at attends at 12 o'clock at night. So we got down and was in the public room, and some young man immediately began to chant, Hare Krishna, at 12 o'clock. So Krishna is so famous. At 12 o'clock, in Athens, who is such a person within this world? This is Bhagavan. Aishadyasya samagrasya vidyasya jasasya. Jasa means reputation. He is so reputed. Anywhere, Krishna is known. So jasasya sriya. Sriya, beauty. Krishna is so beautiful, nobody can surpass him. Kandatpa koti kamaniya visesha sobham. Although he is blackish, but he is so beautiful. He enchants the most beautiful rather than. So, aishadyasa samagrasya vidyasa jasasa sriya. Sri means beauty. He is so beautiful, therefore his name is Krishna. On account of his beauty, he attracts everyone. Beauty attracts. So, nobody can be more beautiful than Krishna. Aishadyasya jasasa sriya. Jnana. Not only he is beautiful, just like a flower, very beautiful to see, but no good smell, no aroma, useless. So Krishna is not only beautiful, but he is the most wise. His book, Bhagavad Gita, 5,000 years ago he spoke. Still, big, big scholars, religionists, philosophers are studying. This is called jnana. Aishadyasya samagrasya vidyasya jasasya sriya jnana. And vairagya. Vairagya means renouncement. So, Krishna claims that he is the proprietor of all the planets. But if you think, where is Krishna, let me find out, he is the proprietor, that you cannot find out. Vairagya. Although he is the proprietor of all the planets, you won't find him within this material world. Although his authority is going on. Just like the president of your country, he is not to be seen everywhere, but his authority is going. Mastani sarvabhutani naham tehi avasthita. Everything is situated on Krishna's opulence. But not that you will find Krishna there. You will find Krishna there when you are advanced. Otherwise, you will not find. Mastani sarvabhutani naham tejavati. Krishna, in Krishna is situated everything. But still you cannot see in Krishna, unless you have got eyes to see. That is Krishna consciousness movement, to give you the eyes to see Krishna everywhere. So how this thing can be done? So, if you are serious, then you can see Krishna, so that Krishna is advising in this verse, in the 7th chapter, or throughout the whole Bhagavad Gita, Krishna is instructing us how to understand. That is our only business. This human form of life is meant for understanding Krishna. Because we are very thickly related with Krishna, just like father and the son. This relation cannot be broken. Maybe son is out of home. Son may have forgotten. But Krishna, the Supreme Father, he does not forget. He comes. Vidajada hi dhanma saglani bhavadivar. Tadatmanam sujami hum. So Krishna is so kind that he has come to explain himself what he is. We should take advantage of it. Because this human form of life is meant for understanding Krishna. Athātam brahma jignyāsa. That is the Vedanta Sutra. Now you should inquire at the absolute truth. In the Bhagavata also it is said, jīvasya tattva jignyāsa nastriha jatkarma hi. Jīvasya, all living entities, especially the human being, his only business is inquire about the absolute knowledge, Krishna. But we are missing the opportunity. Nature has given us the opportunity, possessing this human form of body, after evolution, 8,300,000 different types of bodies. But there is no cultivation of this knowledge. How this evolution is taking place, how many different species of life there are, we can see, but we don't see very seriously. I see there is a tree in front of my house, and it is also a living entity. I am also a living entity. I have got very nice house, apartment, living very comfortably. And the other living, the tree, a few yards from me, he cannot move an inch. He has to stand up in scorching heat and cold. He cannot protest. If you cut, he cannot cry. Of course he feels, but he cannot do anything. So this is also life. And I am also life. So why these differences? But they do not consider how he has got this life and how I have got this life. There is no university education. Where from they are coming? No knowledge. Still, they are passing on, great scientists, great philosophers. This is the position. So, our real business is to understand Krishna. So, Krishna is explaining himself. Then there is no difficulty. If you want to know me, you can imagine so many things. Samiji may be this, Samiji may be that, like that, like this, like that. They are all imperfect. But if I tell you about myself openly, that I am like this, then your knowledge is perfect. So everyone says, there is no God. Somebody says, God is there, but he has no form. And somebody says, he has any form, you like, imagine, any form. In this way, speculation is going on all over the world. Actually, they are not interested in God. That is a plain, simple thing. They do not want to know God, and they think there is no need of understanding. But there is the only need to understand God. That they do not know. Therefore, they are called fools and duskers, mūrā. Mūrā nābhi jānāsi māme bhapparam abhayam. So, Krishna therefore left his instruction behind him, that these mūrās, duskers, after studying Bhagavad-gītā, they may understand me. I am keeping behind me. So we should take advantage of Bhagavad Gita. And even though we take advantage, we interpret in a different way. The same business is going on, how to kill Krishna. Instead of understanding Krishna, the endeavor is going on to kill Krishna, Asura, just like Kamsa. He was always thinking of Krishna. His sister was pregnant, and it is foretold that the eighth child of your sister will kill him. So, he was thinking of Krishna, that the eighth child, but with a purpose to kill him. That is the business of the Asuras. How to wipe out Krishna? Kamsa philosophy. So we haven't got to follow Kamsa philosophy. We have to follow Krishna philosophy. Then our life will be successful. Anukullena Krishnanusilanam Bhakti Yuttama. Anukullena, favorably. Favorably to think of Krishna. As Krishna says, Manvana Bhavamad Bhakta Madhyadi Mang Namaskuru. This is favorable. Krishna never says that like my uncle, Kamsa, you think of me, how to kill me. Krishna does not say that. Krishna says, Manvana Bhavamad Bhakta Madhyadi Mang Namaskuru. That will make your life successful. So here also Krishna says, Maya Sakta Manapatha Yogam Jinjan Madasa. Asamsayam Samagrang Mam Jatha Vyasasi Tatsinu. My dear Arjuna, I have already explained in the sixth chapter that to become first class yogi, when Arjuna was advised by Krishna to become yogi. What is yogi? What is yogi means to train the mind how to become Krishna conscious. The mind is disturbed always, this way, that way, mind is going, chanchal, restless. So the hatha yoga system is meant for persons who are too much under the bodily conception of life, that I am this body. But then the hatha yoga is there. So that by practicing several sitting posture, controlling the mind, controlling the senses, they can concentrate on Krishna or Vishnu, the Supreme Lord. This is yoga system. This is real yoga. Dhyanavastita tadvatena manasa pasyantiyam yogino. He is the yogi. He is yogi in meditation, dhyanavastita tadvatena manasa, always thinking of Krishna by the mind. And gradually, when he is perfect in samadhi, trance, he can see Krishna. Premanyana Charita Bhakti Vilochanena Santa Sadaiva Hridayesu Vilokayanti Jan Shama Sundaram Achinta Gunasarupam Govindamadi Purusham Tamangaya. Shama Sundar, you have come to this temple, here is Shama Sundar's form. You see, always come as many times as you like. See the arati, see the, hear the kirtan, see the deity nicely dressed. In this way, the impression of God will be within your mind. Dhyanavastita tadvati. And when you have got this impression, if you always meditate upon Krishna, as Krishna advises, manmana bhavamad bhakta, manvana, always think of me, That is the perfect yoga system. Therefore, at the end of the sixth chapter, Krishna says, yoginavapi sarvesha madvata antarātmana. Of all the yogis, the Krishna and Arjuna was talking, Krishna advised Arjuna to become a yogi, but Arjuna said that Krishna it is not possible for. Because I am a politician, I am a soldier, I cannot sit down to practice yoga superficially. My mind will be disturbed in political affairs, in state affairs. So, chanchala himmana krishna pramathi balavadriham. My mind is so restless, it is not possible. Then Krishna, to encourage him, said, yoginamapi sarvesham madgata antarātmana sadhyāvān bhajati jūmān samedhiktatamo. Anyone who is thinking of me, always, madgata antarātmana sadhyāvān samedhiktatamo. He is the first class. So we are trying to make our student, the first class yogi, always think of Krishna. This is our Krishna consciousness movement. And Krishna is also saying the same thing. Maya saktamana prātha yogam. How you can think of Krishna always? That is not possible. Unless you become too much addicted. That's right, if you love somebody, then you can think of it always. Artificially, if I say you think of Mr. John always, how is it possible? Artificially it is not possible. If you have got some love for Mr. John as a friend, as a lover, or as somebody, or son, or master or something, then you can think of Mr. John always. Otherwise, not possible. So that thinking, you can revive. There is relationship with you, with Krishna. So you have to revive that relationship. It is not artificial. Just like these European American boys, Krishna was unknown to them. They are coming from Christian Jews. What they have to do is the Krishna. They have nothing to do. But why they are mad after Krishna? They are no longer mad after anything. They have given up everything simply for preaching in your country. They have come here. They have not come as a businessman to exploit African resources like other Europeans. They have come to distribute Krishna consciousness. Why? Why the responsibility they have taken? Because they have learned to love Krishna. This is the basic thing. And you can understand. Otherwise, do you think that poor men, they have come here to earn some money? They are not poor men. The Americans are the richest country. Any third-class man, he earns there 400,000 series. Any third-class man. And what to speak of the first-class man? This is America. The lowest paid to a person, whatever qualification, must be at least $4,000. This is their law. So how they can be poor? There is no question of poverty in America. Nobody thinks, what shall I do next? I have no money. Money is there on the street. Go and take it and spend. So why they have come here? Taking so much troubles, because they love Krishna, therefore they have come. This is the mayasaka, asaka, attached. So you have to increase the attachment. Krishna is already attractive. But we are trying to go away from Krishna. This is our business. Krishna may not touch me. We are so clever that Krishna may not touch me. This is Maya. Big scholars, big politicians, they are writing comments on Krishna's book, Bhagavad Gita, but their aim is very acute, that Krishna may not touch me. This is why. And then why they are writing on Krishna's book? Now that is their business. Because this book, Gita, is very famous. So if they can distribute their nonsense philosophy through Gita, it will be taken very easily. Otherwise, they do not know Krishna, they do not know what is Bhagavad Gita. But they take advantage of the popularity of Bhagavad Gita and push their nonsense philosophy through Bhagavad Gita. The purpose is to kill Krishna. Counter philosophy. So then that way, they will never get Krishna. They will never understand Krishna. Krishna says that if you want to know me, asamsayam, samagram, if you want to know me in full, completely, without any doubt, then you have to follow this yoga system, maya saptamana pratha, yogam jinjana madha. Otherwise it is not possible. So all these nonsense speculators, we use purposefully nonsense, because there is no sense. Simply speculate. God is unlimited. How your mind is limited. What you can speculate. Maybe like this, maybe like that, that's all. Perhaps it is like this. All simply theoretical. It is never possible to know Krishna, God, perfectly and completely by this speculating method. It is not possible. If you want to know Krishna or God, when you speak of Krishna, God, so then Krishna's formula must be followed. As it is said here, maya saptamana prartha yogam yunyan madasa. The principal factor is to become attached to Krishna. Attached means become a lover of Krishna. Then you can understand asamsayam, without any doubt. Without any doubt. Otherwise, you will find there are so many hundreds of religious systems all over the world. Ask any of their followers, do you know what is God? They will never be able to answer clearly. Because they do not know God. And if you do not know God, then what is the meaning of your religion? Religion means to know God. Dhanvantu sāksād bhagavat pranītam. One must know God, and one must know what God desires. There is religion. Just like you must know your government, and you must know what government wants, expects from it. If you do that, then you are a good citizen. And if you don't know what is government, if you do not know what government desires, expects from you, then what is the meaning of your good citizenship? There is no meaning. Similarly, to become religious, without any clear understanding of God is bogus, is cheating. That is cheating. That is not real. Therefore Krishna said that if you want to know me, asamsayam, without any doubt, God may be personal, impersonal, or this, that, but you must know it perfectly. Don't say, perhaps it may be like this, perhaps it may be like this. That is impersonal knowledge. That is no knowledge. So therefore Krishna personally says, Maya saktam mana prakha yogam janya. This is a yoga. This is the first class yoga. Krishna has explained that yoginam ki sarvesam madgatam taratmana sadhyavan bhajati yumam samedhu. So, sadhyavan bhajati yumam, one who is worshipping Krishna with sadhya, with faith, complete faith, bhajate, I am serving him. So who is that person? A devotee. Without being a devotee, how with faith and adherence and reverence and obedience you can serve Krishna unless you love Krishna? So maya saktamana prartha. There we have got attraction for so many things in this material world. Somebody has got attraction for his family. Somebody has got attraction for his wife, children. Or somebody has got attraction for some sporting. Or somebody has attraction for his country. So on. We have got attraction. That is not a new thing. We have got attraction. But we have got attraction in different subject matter. Material. So, this yoga system, bhakti yoga system means you should be only attracted by Krishna. That is what. Attraction is there. Nobody can say that I have no attraction for anything. That is false. Everyone has got attraction. If you have nothing to be attracted, then you keep a cat and a dog to be attracted. That is the nature, especially in the Western country, you see. He has no family, but he keeps one pet dog, a pet cat, because he wants to be attracted by somebody. This is nature. So here Krishna says that you have got already attraction, but in false things which will not exist. You turn that attraction unto me, then you get pleasure. You are attracted to something for getting some pleasure. So that pleasure is interrupted because we have posed our attraction in some false things. You have to change that attraction to the real thing, Krishna. Then you will be happy. Mayasa. To me, Krishna says personally. If you, attraction means you have to engage your mind. Mayasakta mana. Attraction does not come in the air. The mind. Mind fully engaged in something is called attraction. So, this is yoga, bhakti yoga. And this yoga has to be executed, Krishna said, madasraya. You have to execute this yoga system, taking shelter of me. Me means either Krishna himself or he is represented. Just like Krishna says in the fourth chapter, evaṁ parampara prāptam imaṁ rāja sayogudu. So, you have to learn this bhakti yoga directly under Krishna or under the direction of Krishna's representation. So if you do this, then a samsara, without any doubt, and samagra, incompleteness, maya sakta, asamsara samagrama, jatha agyasasi tatsini. Kali Krishna explained, item by item, how you can increase your attraction for Krishna, then you will be able to execute the bhakti yoga system under the guidance of Krishna directly or directed by his representative, then it will be successful. So one of the Krishna's representatives, Srila Rupa Goswami, he has defined how this attachment can be increased. He has explained, sadhu sadhya, tato sadhu sangha. Sadhu sadhya, because you have come here with some sadhya, some faith, this is required. And you have to increase this sadhya, this faith, more and more. How it can be increased? Sadhu sangha, to intermingle with the persons who are engaged in Krishna consciousness. Adu sadhya tatu sadhu sangha. Sadhu means he is a devotee of Krishna. Otherwise he is not sadhu. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, apiche sudurachara bhajate imamananna bhak sadhu reva samantam. That is sadhu. You cannot create sadhu unless he is devotee of Krishna. Bhajate imamananna bhak. He is sadhu. So if you want to increase your advancement in Krishna consciousness, then you have to intermingle with the person who is sadhu, who are sadhu and devotees. Adho sadhya tatho sadhu sangha. But sadhu sangha, then gradually you will be inclined to execute devotional service as the sadhus are doing, chanting Hare Krishna mantra, offering arati, offering foodstuff, dressing, so many things. Savanam kirtanam Vishnu smaranam padasivanam achanam bandhanam das. The nine different types of methods, that is called bhajanakriya. And adau sadhya tato sadhu adau bhajanakriya tato anartha nivittisya. Then anartha, all unwanted things which you have learned unfortunately, that will be finished. If you mix with intermingle with sadhu, then you will be purified, and things which are not required at all, artificially you have learned by bad association, that will be anartha nivittisya. Nobody learns to smoke from the very birth. He has to eat something. He drinks milk, the child. He doesn't say, give me a cigarette. But you have learned it by bad association. This is called anartha. You have learned it, drinking tea, coffee, not from the beginning of your life, but by bad association. Then this is anartha. So if you engage yourself in devotional service, then these things will be said automatically. You'll find in our temple, we are cooking so many nice preparations, perhaps you have tasted some of them, but you are not preparing tea or coffee or meat, nothing. And these are all anartha. What is this necessity? So anartha nivittisya. Then you become purified. Then you become, when anartha nivittisya, when you are free from all these unwanted nonsense things, illicit sex, intoxication, gambling, and meat eating, this is anartha. Then you've been purified, then your faith in Krishna becomes confirmed. Anartha nivittisya, आदौ श्रद्धया ततो साधसंग ततो भजन क्रिया अतानार्थ निमित्त ततो निष्ठा then become firmly fixed. Yes, I shall continue, Krishna. Nishtha, how is nishtha? Attribution? No, ruchi, taste. You cannot do without Krishna consciousness. That is called tato nishtha, tato ruchi, tato bhava. Oh, Krishna is so exalted. Sadhukha ramayam primno pragut bhavi bhavat karma. This is the step-by-step increasing perfection of Krishna consciousness. And when you are on the perfectional state of Krishna consciousness, then your human life is perfect. This is Krishna consciousness. Thank you very much. Reduce sex. Because material life means sex. Janamaitanadigrihamedisukammitucham. In the material world, not only in the human society, but also in the birds, beasts, animals, insects, everywhere, the sex impulse is very strong. And if you indulge in sex life, then you will be complicated more and more in this material body. This is the law of nature. Therefore, whole Vedic civilization is meant for curtailing sex life. First of all, brahmacharya, no sex life. First of all, training is brahmacharya. How to train him to remain without sex? That is brahmacharya. Tapasa brahmacharyena. Tapasa means to remain brahmacharya. This is tapasa. It is very difficult. Therefore it is called tapasa. Because the whole world is attracted by sex life. Pungshan, Sriya, Mithuna. Bhava. Whole world, not only in this planet, every planet, even in the demigod's planet. So, our this Krishna consciousness movement means not bodily consciousness. The material world means bodily consciousness. How to keep the body in comfortable? But that is not possible. Body means misery. You cannot keep it in comfort. That is Maya. It will never be comfortable, but they are all trying to make it comfortable. This is called Maya. Kresha da asadeha. So long you will have a material body, you will have to suffer. So this Krishna consciousness movement is not on the bodily platform. It is on the spiritual platform. To come to the spiritual platform, it is necessary that you reduce or make mean sex life. So, if one remains brahmachari throughout the whole life, it becomes very easy for him to go back to home. Back to home. This is the secret. Therefore the whole Vedic civilization is based on, first of all, brahmachari, no sexual. Grihastha, that is also very regulated. Only for begetting child one can have sex. Father, mother, man and woman. So, dharma viruddha, kamasmi, in the Bhagavad Gita, you find Krishna says, the sex life which is prescribed by the religious system, that is aham. Otherwise, it is illicit sex. So illicit sex, there is punishment. These things are there. So, tapasya means tapasya brahmacharjina samena dameneva. They have to control. The more one controls, he becomes advanced in spiritual culture. The yoga system means yoga indriya sanyama. Yoga means how to control the senses. This is yoga system. Therefore Krishna says, maya sakta manatva. So, sex indulgence is against spiritual advancement of life. Therefore you have seen that the brahmachari they go, they become very easy to enter into the spiritual kingdom. So that you can do here also. If you increase your attraction for Krishna, then naturally you lose attraction for sex. That is Krishna consciousness. Therefore Krishna's name is Madan Maha. Madan means sex life. He can enchant him, Madan. So these are things which the devotee will learn by studying the literature. But even without studying, if you sincerely chant Hare Krishna mantra under regulation, everything, all good qualification will come.
Brahma is Vishnu. My question is that in Krishna consciousness, is there any part where the emission Adam and Eve in Krishna consciousness?
Says that according to Krishna consciousness philosophy, the first living being was Brahma. And in the Christian Bible, it says Adam was the first man. So he wants to know if in Krishna consciousness scriptures there is any mention of Adam.
So why you want to tally with Bible and Krishna conscious literature? Do you think that Krishna conscious literature has to tally with Bible? There is first living being, Brahma. And Brahma has also married Kapoor. So you can take it as Adam and Eve, that's all. Why do you want 10% tally? But this nonsense theory that there was a monkey, first of all. In Darwin's theory. And from monkey, human being has come. This is nonsense. So, any other question?
Some of the religions, the guru, if someone wants to be his disciple, he is being given a sort of beads by the guru himself. Is it possible to get beads through your worship?
Yes, that is our process. When we accept a disciple, we give him beads, we give him direction.
We chant for Krishna
and Rama both, but this moment glorifies the Krishna's pastime and not much of Rama. Yes, there is. Vaishnava, Ramayana is also approved. Ramayana is also Vedic literature. Valmiki Ramayana, not any other. So we discuss Valmiki Ramayana. In the Bhagavad, there is discussion about Ramchandra's activities. So we are giving Srimad Bhagavatam. There is Ramchandra's activities there. Where is Ramchandra? Which planet he is now? That is also described in the Bhagavatam. See, it is not that we are without Ram. And our direct worshipable Rama is Balaram. Krishna Balaram. We have opened the temple of Krishna Balaram in Vrindavan. So Rama is there. Ramadi Muttisu Kalaniyamena Krishnan Nana Avatara Makarat Bhuvaneshwarin. Krishna has well many incarnations. Rama is also one of them. So any speak of Krishna, it means including all the incarnations. Rama Nishinga Baraha. Everything. Ramadi, therefore Ramadi, taking Rama as the original. Muttisu. In such forms, Ramadi Muttisu, Kalaniyamena Krishna. He is existing. Krishna is not alone. He is always existing with his different incarnations. Rama Nishinga Baraha Matsa Kurma. So many. So, either you worship Krishna or Rama, Nishinga, Varaha, Matsa, Kurma, anyone you can worship. No, don't say that don't worship Rama. You never say. Because Rama and Krishna are the same. We shall, in future we have got a hope, we shall start a Ram Lakshan Murti in some temple. That is our worshipable deity. We have got in my room Lord Ramchandra's Murti, Sitaram. So it is not that we are neglecting worship of Ramchandra. There is. Yes? Somebody else?
Srila Prabhupada, Krishna has been personally glorious. His control of everything, whole universe, everything. So why is having this difficult to help him? Because his control has everything, and we have got power to control all the universe. And one hour of all these temples, which stands in the universe, even the universe, why he can control this universe?
He can control everyone, but he has given little freedom that he does not interfere the freedom given to you. Otherwise, he can control. Just like in Bhagavad Gita, he'll find, after explaining Bhagavad Gita to Arjuna, he's giving the freedom to Arjuna. Jate chasi tatha kuru. Whatever you like, you do. He's supreme controller, he can force him to do it, but he doesn't do that. The little independence you have got, you have to utilize it favorably. Therefore, Krishna says, sarva-dharmān parityajya māmekaṁ saraṇaṁ braja. He do this. He can possibly make me to do that, but he doesn't do that. Because he has given little independence. And he wants that voluntarily you surrender, not by force. That is what. Otherwise, it is not that he cannot control you. He can control everyone.
When we are preaching to Christian people or to Muslim people, is there advantage in being familiar with their scriptures or simply Bhagavati Krishna Bhagavatam?
We are not preaching to Christian or Hindu or Muslim. We are teaching to human beings. We do not see here is a Christian, here is a Muslim, here is a Hindu, here is a white man, here is a black man. No. Every living being, his duty is to understand God. This is our preaching. This is our preaching, that you are living being, you are part and parcel of Krishna. This designation that you are Hindu, you are Muslim, you are Christian, you are this, these are all designations. Actually, you are living being, part and parcel of Krishna. Therefore, your main duty is to understand Krishna. This is our preaching. You are not going to convert Hindu into Muslim, Muslim into Christian. No, that is not our duty. He may think that he is Christian, he is Hindu, he is Muslim, but we think that he is a spirit soul, part and parcel of God. That is stated in the word. Vidyavinaya sampanne brahmane gavihastini sunichita sapate pandita samadarushina. If one is learned pandit, he does not see Hindu, Muslim, Christian. I went to America. I did not go there to turn the Christian to become Hindu. No, I never said. Did I say anyone that you are Christian, you become Hindu? No. Never I said. That is not my business.
Just when you say we all part and parcel of God, what would you say is God?
That we have explained, what is God? Asaṁ-sāyaṁ-sāma-brahmā jathāryāsya-sita-acchinu. You have to become God-conscious, then you'll understand what is God. It is not a so trifle thing, you ask me and 1 minute you understand God. That is foolishness. You have to study the science of God. God is not so cheap. Manushanam sahasyesu kaschid yatati siddhaye yatadamati siddhanam kaschid vettimam tat. Out of many thousands of men, one wants to become perfect. And out many millions of perfect men, one can understand God. So God is not so cheap. Therefore Krishna recommends, mayya sattamana prattha yogam jinjana madasa. If you want to know God without any doubt, completely, then you have to adopt this yoga. So first of all, come to this yoga. Then speak of God, understanding. It is not such a cheap thing.